Hi, everyone. My name is Priyanka Chaudhary. I'm a big data architect in Amazon Web Services. Today in Analytics in 15, we're going to discuss about simplify ETL code, tracking, testing, and deployment. So nowadays, a lot of companies are using lots of code repositories to track their version controls of their ETL transformation jobs and scripts. So this particular demo will showcase how AWS ETL tool, which is AWS Glue, can directly be integrated with the CodeCommit and GitHub. So let's start with that. So let's go to the agenda first. In my agenda today, we're going to introduce our AWS Glue ETL tool. And then we're going to talk about like what Git integration you can do. Basically, we're going to target more about Git integration because AWS CodeCommit is already like integrated directly with the AWS Glue. So you don't have to do any particular integration over here. So we're going to more focus about how Git can be integrated with AWS Glue. And the third, in the later stage, we're going to talk about what we can achieve with help of this Glue and Git integration. And we do have some in the later time, we're going to discuss about like how you can do that, a little demo of the whole integration. And we'll showcase how you can pull the script version from the GitHub, and or you can push the version to the GitHub again. So let's start with that. So let's focus on our first agenda item, which is called AWS Glue introduction. So what is AWS Glue? AWS Glue is a simple, scalable, and serverless ETL tool, which is present in AWS infrastructure. You don't have to manage any server over here because it is like serverless. And you can integrate almost 70 plus sources. And so basically any machine learning engineer or data analytics person can discover their data from there. It's an integration tool. So basically you can discover your data, you can do the ETL capabilities, you can do like a centralized catalog with the help of AWS Glue. Since this demo, this whole presentation will be walking around like a ETL perspective of AWS Glue. So we're gonna focus more on ETL capabilities of AWS Glue. So you can automate that with scale. So you can use auto scaling with AWS Glue. You don't have to decide how many workers you need to run your workload. Instead, you can do the auto scaling directly, and you don't have to worry about how many compute needs are there for your Glue job. So it will be decided by machine learning capabilities at the back end of AWS Glue, which can your upscale or downscale your compute capabilities. There is no servers to manage, so you don't have to manage any infrastructure. You just need to set up your Glue scripts, and that's it. You can run any ETL transformation over here. If you are new to the any coding capabilities for you, I mean, you can do the diagrammatic transformations as well. You can choose, pick and choose which transformation you need. You can choose it, and you can work on your transformations. And the good thing about using AWS Glue, it has built-in Spark and Python capabilities. You can write your code in PySpark. And in fact, you can do the Python shell scripting as well with the AWS Glue. Now let's discuss like what changed with AWS Glue and how you can integrate Git with AWS Glue. So now AWS Glue offers enable version management and CI/CD as well. So there is a new tab was introduced in last year in 2022. In Glue Studio, you can go to the version control. You can go there and put your GitHub information or code commit information, and you can connect your Git directly to the Glue. And for now, we do have like AWS CodeCommit and GitHub supported as of now, but there will be new features coming up as well. So right now, our main focus will be GitHub integration with AWS Glue. So let's go to the next slide. So what capabilities you can do with AWS Glue Git integration? So that's the next slide for ours. So you can track your changes to your ETL code. So basically, not only your script can be tracked with AWS, with the GitHub, this version controlling. Instead, you can track your configuration changes as well. So if you want to change the workers, if you want to change the max retries or something, so you can track those changes as well in GitHub. So that's the magic of using Glue Git integration. So basically, it will create a JSON file for you at the back end. And you can see like what configuration you have created for your AWS Glue and what script you are running for your AWS Glue. So next is like you can deploy Glue jobs with your existing pipelines and DevOps tools. So basically, you don't have to worry about like you need to create any mediator to connect your GitHub with the AWS Glue. You can now you have this version control directly from AWS Glue, and you can directly link your code from your console to the GitHub. So far it supports GitHub and AWS CodeCommit, and you can download and upload AWS Glue jobs in AWS Management Console. So meaning like if you want to push the changes from console to the GitHub, you can do that, and you can do pull from the repository as well. So it supports both push and pull from for the versioning control. So there is a direct integration available, so pull and push capabilities are there as well. So now, since we already talked about like how you can do the Glue Git integration, now let's go to our demo and we can see like how you can achieve that. So now let's go to the demo here. For the sake of the time, I have already created a Glue job in my console. So I'm going to that job. This is a straightforward demo job I have created. In this job, like I have only added like a very simple filter transformations and getting the data from S3 and do some transformations, and that's it. For the sake of the time, let's go to our version control directly. And here is the tab. You can see this version control is there. And since I have done some of the commits earlier also, so that's why you are seeing this. You can ignore this message as of now. But you can see that like you can choose over here what kind of configuration you need. So you can choose from AWS CodeCommit versus GitHub over here. So since this demo is around how GitHub can be integrated with the AWS Glue, so I'm going to focus on GitHub over here. So to connect with GitHub with AWS Glue, what you need to do, you need to create a personal access token. How you can do that, you can go to your GitHub profile over here. And in your profile, you can go to your developer settings over here. And you can create your personal access token from here. Since I have already created this token, I'm going to use the token which I have already created. So let's go back to our screen, and I'm grabbing my token over here. So this is a token, and I'm putting the owner is this. Now you can see that it will not show me any repository. We need to refresh the screen so that Glue will directly connect to our GitHub. Now you can see that I have two repositories are there, Glue version log or CDK test. So this particular repository, I'm using it for this demo. So I do have an option to choose which branch to go, whether it's a developer branch or it's a main branch. Since I'm doing this demo directly on the main, so I'm choosing main branch directly. And it will give me the option like, okay, what is the name of the folder you want to create? So I am creating this particular folder in my GitHub. Now let me save this version control setting over here. Now let's go and make some changes and see the magic. So in my script, let me add one import library just for the sake of this demo. And in my job details, I am increasing the workers to 15 and number of retries to maybe 5, okay? So let's save this setting. So now we know that in my current settings, we have made a lot of changes. And now you can see that the version control settings are already there. Now it's time to push the changes to our repository over here. So it's already connecting to our GitHub and one new commit has been created. So let's go to this commit and see what changes we have done. So you can see that we have added this particular script change and the JSON file, we have added this max retries 5 and number of workers as 15. So you can see this code commit is already being done. And let's go to our this repo and see the changes over here. Let's refresh it. So you can see the changes are already being seen over here. And our JSON file, you can see that our max retries is 5. And we have changed the number of workers to 15 as well. Similarly, we do have our changes of adding this import OS directory. Import has been added to the script. Now, since we already saw that push is working fine, let's go to our pull to the repository option as well. So now I'm making the changes from here and I'm removing this particular import from here so that it will get back to the change whatever I had. And now let's go to the our JSON file as well. Let's see. Okay. In our JSON file, I'm making the changes again. So max retries, I'm changing it to 10. And number of workers, I'm changing it to 10 as well. So I'm committing the changes. Okay, so I have done the changes in my Git repo. And now I want the same version of both the configured JSON file as well as script over here as well. So for that, what we're gonna do is like, we can pull from repository over here and it will ask you like whether you wanna do that or not. And you wanna link it with main branch or all the settings are correct or not. So I'm confirming it. So you can see this, my commit is changed now. So now it is matching with the whatever commit I have done over here. So let's go to the studio again. Okay, let's go to the script. Now you can see that that import is removed and also my requested number of workers is changed to 10 and number of retries are changed to 10 as well. So yeah, so that's how you can integrate your jobs to the GitHub and you can maintain your version control. Similarly, whatever we have done with GitHub, you can choose the option of code commit and you can provide your repository name. I don't have any existing repository, so it is showing me empty. But if you have a repository created and branch is created, then you can directly cover up over here and you can play with that with code commit as well. Since the demo was more on the GitHub side, so I have created this particular demo on GitHub. So let's go to our slide again. So that's how this GitHub is integrated with the Idar thing. So now let's summarize what we have done so far. So we saw that how AWS Glue has a new feature created, like with version control, you can directly pull and push the changes. So that was the intention of this particular presentation. I hope you have learned something new. Thank you so much. That's it from my side. Thank you.